There's a lot we don't know about morning sickness, and I don't just mean why it's called morning sickness when the urge to vomit can happen at any time of the day. I mostly mean why morning sickness is a thing, like biologically. It affects so many pregnant people and the people in their lives that we've already done a video that covered some of the potential causes. But that was, get ready for it, 10 years ago. And it turns out that we were mere bit players. Since that video came out, the real primary culprit has been found. And if scientists can understand its relationship to pregnancy, we may be able to stop a lot of unnecessary and sometimes life-threatening barfing. Since morning sickness is such a misnomer, we're going to stick to what researchers call it, nausea and vomiting of pregnancy, or NVP. But whatever you choose to call it, while you or your partner is swearing off certain foods or hovering over the toilet bowl, NVP affects about 7 out of 10 pregnant people, and it's usually felt in the first 3 months of pregnancy. But for some people, it's even worse, like vomiting more than 3 times a day for all 9 months. And in that case, we call it HG, short for hyperemesis gravidarum. HG affects less than 3% of pregnant people, but more than 2%, which sounds like too much. And many of those people need intravenous fluids to replace nutrients they've lost. The side effects can be severe, if not life-threatening, so scientists have spent decades hunting for the best treatment options. For example, in the late 1950s and early 1960s, many doctors prescribed thalidomide to treat both NVP and HG. Unfortunately, that came with some incredibly tragic consequences. And thankfully, these days, we have safe anti-nausea medications available instead. They are not a cure, though. And to find one, researchers have to understand exactly why NVP and HG exist at all. As we covered all those years ago, there are a number of hypotheses, including the possibility that pregnant people are just more sensitive to smells and tastes because that means they're more likely to detect and thus avoid spoiled food. Because spoiled food isn't exactly something that a growing body or the person growing that body needs to be dealing with right now. But why does NVP happen to some people and not others? Up until recently, the answer was simply, we don't know. Then scientists realized that by looking at the biological and more specifically genetic differences between nauseated and non-nauseated pregnant people, they could identify some answers. The last time we covered NVP, aka morning sickness, scientists thought that elevated levels of a hormone called HCG might be to blame. Hormones are proteins that the body produces to send messages to various tissues throughout the body. Unfortunately, the data haven't really supported that. There just isn't conclusive evidence that HCG affects the amount of nausea a person feels during pregnancy. But since that video came out, another hormone has entered the arena as a major, if not the major, cause of NVP. Growth differentiation factor 15, aka GDF15. GDF15 is found in everyone's body, whether you're capable of getting pregnant or not. It's part of your natural stress response, and its abundance increases in a bunch of different situations, like if you get exposed to something toxic. And GDF15 does its job mostly by binding to a specific kind of receptor in your brain and issuing the order to your body, okay, time to throw up now. In other words, it's a pretty decent place to start looking if you want to identify causes of nausea and vomiting during pregnancy.
Thank you to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform with thousands of lessons in computer science, math, and science. When you're learning computer science, you can't get more knowledgeable instruction than from the professionals at Microsoft, Google, MIT, and all the other top-tier places that Brilliant gets their award-winning team from. On your very first day with Brilliant, you'll be building programs and getting familiar with Python. That's the kind of hands-on learning that you can't just get anywhere. And while you're learning about computer science, you're building critical thinking skills through problem solving rather than memorizing. You can get started at brilliant.org/scishow or at the link in the description. And that link will also give you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription, plus you'll get your first 30 days for free.
So as early as 2000, researchers identified that people's blood serum tended to have more elevated levels of GDF15 during pregnancy, but that only suggested there was a correlation between GDF15 and NVP, not necessarily that the hormone caused it. Finally, in 2018, researchers published a study that showed there was a genetic component to having high GDF15 levels in pregnancy, and a follow-up study published in 2022 looked at genomes from over 1,500 pregnant people, over 900 of which had to undergo treatment for HG, with the rest having either normal NVP or no NVP symptoms. The team was able to identify a few mutated versions in the gene that codes for GDF15 that were associated with the more severe HG condition. In other words, if you have one of these mutations, you are more likely to have worse nausea and vomiting during your pregnancy. So it appeared that GDF15 did seem to play some kind of causal role. And then, a paper published online in 2023 proposed how the problem of GDF15 is really one of sensitization. The idea is that basically due to their genetics, some people have a very low baseline amount of GDF15 in their body. But both a placenta and a fetus make tons of GDF15. So if that person gets pregnant, they experience a sudden, huge spike in GDF15 levels that leads to more severe nausea. But you might be thinking, why would a fetus be pumping out a hormone that can make their parents sick for months? Well, in addition to its role in puking, GDF15 also suppresses certain immune signaling proteins, which do basically what their name suggests. By releasing GDF15, a fetus ensures that even though it's a foreign body, its parents' immune system won't panic and try to get rid of it. This is why experiencing NVP is correlated with having a lower chance to lose the pregnancy. To test their sensitization hypothesis, the researchers injected non-pregnant mice with either a placebo or a medium-level amount of GDF15. Not enough to induce nausea, but enough to increase their baseline. Then, 3 days later, they gave all of the mice an injection full of GDF15 and observed the results. The mice that were first given the placebo ate less and lost weight consistent with the symptoms of nausea. Meanwhile, the mice that had been pre-treated with GDF15 didn't have much of a response to the second larger dose. However, the team didn't just look at mice. They showed that if a human fetus had a gene associated with producing less GDF15, their parent experienced less nausea and puking. And they also found that people who had higher levels of GDF15 before getting pregnant had less nausea while pregnant. So it looks like NVP is a side effect of GDF15 levels spiking from really low to really high, not just being high. And the question, of course, is can we use this knowledge to help us prevent NVP? If having a higher level of GDF15 circulating through your body really does help protect against NVP, then some kind of graduated exposure to GDF15 pre-pregnancy could help desensitize the people who are most at risk. And scientists have already tested ways to use GDF15 as a therapeutic for other conditions. So this could merely be an extension of that research. Or maybe a future drug could prevent GDF15 molecules from doing their hormone job, like by blocking them from interacting with the right receptors in your brain. In fact, some of these drugs have made it to clinical trials to see how they can manage nausea in cancer patients. However, a lot of experiments looking into this line of drug development have only been done in mice. And mice don't typically experience GDF15 shifts during pregnancy, so more research is definitely needed. It's still gonna be a while before we start seeing commercials for an FDA-approved anti-morning sickness pill. But the past few years suggest that NVP is something you or your partner or anyone growing a mini-me inside of them doesn't have to endure. They will just still have to endure all of the other side effects that come with pregnancy instead.